愿主与你们同在，
与你的心灵同在。
恭读圣马尔谷福音。那时候，耶稣对群众说：“天主的国好像一个人，把种子撒在地里，他夜间睡觉，白天起来，那种子发芽生长。怎么会这样？他也不知道，因为土壤自然而然的生长果实。”先发苗，后吐穗，最后穗上结满了麦粒。果实成熟了，他便立刻派人用镰刀收割，因为收获的时期到了。耶稣又说：“我们用什么来比拟天主的果呢？或用什么比喻来形容它呢？它好像一粒芥菜种子，种在地里的时候，比地上的一切种子都小，种下之后生长起来，却比一切的蔬菜都大，长出大枝子，甚至统攻天上的飞鸟，在它的荫下搭窝。”耶稣用许多类似的比喻，按照他们所能听懂的，给他们讲道。他不用比喻，就不对他们讲话，但是四下却把一切解释给门徒听。基督的福音。
基督，我们赞美你。
亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，在今天的福音当中，我们听见耶稣告诉我们两个比喻，这两个比喻都关于种子。而在比喻当中，耶稣透过撒种以及观察他们如何成长和长成什么，而来让我们对于天国有一些了解。实际上，天子的国已经在人们的中间，耶稣在哪里，那里就是天主的国。当人们在耶稣内有信德，那么他就在他们中间。透过这样子的方式，天主的国显示出来。有了这样的想法，我们不难理解，第一个种子的比喻是有关于宣讲好消息的故事。耶稣已经开始宣讲福音，而且是慢慢的，并且真的已经开始了，这是无法阻挡的。就如同一颗种子发芽以及长大，然后结出果实，那宣扬天主的好消息也会继续宣讲到远处，最后就会有信仰的果实。第二个故事是关于芥子。也许这个故事就是关于耶稣自己本身，他就像这个小小的芥子。相比较那些高高在上的领袖，他似乎是不重要的。与过去伟大的先知相比，他是渺小的，但实际上他却是超越他们所有人。事实是，他是最伟大的那一位，他就是人们所说的那一位墨西亚，世界的救主。 从读经一的厄泽克尔先知书，我们可以看到香柏树的一根嫩芽将会在高山处栽种，长成了高大的香柏。在这两个故事当中，我们可以看到小鸟栖息甚至筑巢在那棵大树上。各位教友，这两个比喻也可以与我们每一个人都有关系。当我们听见了耶稣的福音以及接受他，那么这就会像是在我们心中种下这小小的心得种子。这小小的心得种子会在我们中不断成长，那我们就会随着时间的推移越来越信靠天主，也会越来越置身于天主的事业当中。这也意味着心得将我们转化成神圣的人，虔诚的人，一位圣者就是成为天主爱与和平的工具。当他人与我们相遇，他们可在我们这里栖息，就像小鸟在树上的枝条上栖息。那些有困难的就会找到帮助，那些有痛苦的会得到安慰，那些生病的也会得到治愈，那些迷失的会再次找到他们的方向，那些寻找天主的就会找到他。透过我们每一个人，耶稣再次临在于这个世界上。是的，耶稣就是那个戒指，是的，我们也是那个戒指。我们的使命是多么伟大，成为另外一个耶稣，我们能做得到吗？是的，我们能，因为我们是凭着信德活着，以及基督就在我们每一个人当中。让我们带着谦卑的心，感谢天主给予我们这个召教，也让我们充满信心地向天主祈求在这世上建造天国的恩宠。In today's gospel, we heard Jesus telling us two parables. Both of these were about seeds. And he uses these parables about sowing seeds and seeing how they grow and what they grow to become to give us some idea about the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God was in fact already in the midst of the people. Where Jesus was, there was the kingdom of God. And when people have faith in Jesus, there he is in their midst. In this way, the kingdom of God becomes present. Now with this in mind, we can see the story of the first seed as a story about the preaching of the gospel, the preaching of the good news. Jesus has begun to preach the good news, and this message is now slowly but surely starting to spread. It is unstoppable. As surely as the seed that is sprouting and growing will continue to grow until it produces a harvest, so too the preaching of the good news will continue to spread far and wide and will bring about a harvest of faith in God. Now the story of the second seed, which is identified as the mustard seed, is perhaps a story about Jesus himself. He is like the little mustard seed. He seems so insignificant to the great leaders of the people. He seems so little compared to the great prophets of the past, but he is in fact even greater than all those who came before him. Why is he the greatest? Because he in fact is the Messiah, the Savior of the world. This idea we can also link to today's first reading from the prophet Ezekiel about the shoot of the cedar that will be planted on a very high mountain and become a great cedar. In both of these stories, we are told also about the birds that will take shelter and even nest in the branches of the fully grown tree. This mention of the birds also gives us a clue that both of these stories could be linked. I think the birds are very interesting to think about because they represent all of us. Now, when we hear the good news of Jesus and accept it, it is also like having a seed of faith planted in our hearts. This little seed of faith grows and grows in us, and we become day by day more and more devoted to God, more and more committed to doing His work on earth. This means that faith transforms us into a holy person, a godly person. As a holy person, we become God's instrument of love and peace. Now, once you are God's instrument of love and peace, when people encounter you, they can take shelter in you, just like the birds that take shelter in the branches of a tree. Those who are in trouble, they will find help. Those suffering, you will comfort them. Those who are sick, you will heal them. Those who are lost, with your help, they will find their way again. And those who are searching for God will find Him. Through each one of us, Jesus becomes present again in this world. Yes, Jesus is the mustard seed, and yes, so too each one of us. How great a mission we have to be another Jesus. In Latin, they say alter Christus, yeah? Another Jesus, another Christ. Can we do it? Yes, because we walk by faith. And because Christ is in each one of us. So with humility, let us give thanks to God for this great calling, and let us, full of confidence, pray for the grace to build the kingdom of God here on earth.